Now, as we watch what's happening in Ukraine from the other side of the world, many are asking how they can help.
One Kiwi isn't just asking, he's taking action and has made the trip over to help the animals caught up in the chaos.
On the streets of Ukraine, animals are oblivious to the politics, but not the consequences. Yet amongst such tragedy are people who remind you of the good. Volunteers who stayed despite the dangers, rescuing the ones left behind and reuniting those forced apart, finding safe spaces across the border when there are few left at home. Now a Kiwi is among those determined to help, working with local shelters to coordinate support and supplies, a small act to help some of those most affected. And Tim Gronendal is here now from Kiev in Ukraine. Thank you so much for your time, Tim. Tell us a bit about why you wanted to go and help.
Well, put simply, it was a pretty tragic situation, and most New Zealanders, well, many New Zealanders have companion animals at home. So I guess we felt a strong kind of connection to some of the pictures that you were seeing on the television. So the first thing I did is I rang around some leaders of major charities in the Ukraine and Europe to find out kind of what the need was, what some of the problems they were having, to ascertain if there was anything I could do to help. I sit on the board of SAFE, so I have a keen interest in animals and some understanding of how charities work. So I found out pretty quickly where I might be able to help, and one of them asked me if I would want to help, and here I am.
What's the situation on the ground over there, Tim? What's daily life like?
Well, it's a very good question. I've just woken up, and the reason I have unruly hair is I didn't manage to have a shower because an air raid siren went off twice overnight, one at around midnight and then one at about 3 a.m, which is quite confronting, as you could probably imagine. So I had to jump out of bed quickly, put my shoes on, run 2 flights of stairs down in the apartment building where I'm staying into a bunker, and then wait for the all-clear siren to sound before I could go back to bed. So I just managed to get to sleep, and then off it went again. So feeling a little bit sleepy, but hopefully making some sense.
You are making sense, and we're glad that you're safe too. Tell me, what's been the response from the local shelters and the charities that you're helping?
Twofold, I guess. In the first instance, a bit of a novelty, probably. They think having a New Zealander is not common, which surprised me. But then secondly, more importantly, I mean, they're overwhelmed and wracked. Obviously, I'm playing a small part. The humanitarian crisis is enormous, as well as the effect on animals. But they are just thrilled that I think anyone from overseas has come here, and the more support that Ukrainian people can get from around the world, particularly when it's probably not the leading news story anymore, I think is really important. So we can just keep continuing that conversation about what's happening, like what we're doing now, I guess.
And Tim, how can people help support the work that you're doing?
In two ways, I guess. One, just spread the word, and secondary, monetarily. So if you go to animalsforanimals.world or on the Instagram page with the same name, you'll see some information about what we're doing, and you can help by posting a photo of your companion animal at home and decorate it with some of our stickers, and that would be amazing if you could do that.
Thanks so much, Tim. Appreciate your time tonight.
Thank you.